In 1968 in Mexico was the Mexican student movement. What differentiated it from these other movements in Paris and in New York was that it was quickly joined by farmers and workers unions. So it became very fast, very, very powerful. A student was killed in a demonstration in July of that year, made things more critical. And then the other thing that was that differentiated Mexico was that the Olympics, the Summer Olympics, were going to take place on the 12th of October. So the government really had to do something to put an end to our movement. And what they chose to do was a massacre on the 2nd of October, which was probably my most... it was the moment in my life so far in my 80 years that really shook me the most, because it taught me what an authoritarian government is willing to do to get its way, you know. And 1,000 people were killed that day. It was a massacre that lasted for 5 hours. We staged a peaceful demonstration in a place called Tlatelolco, Plaza of Three Cultures. It was a sort of housing project with high-rise housing on one side and remnants of an Aztec ruin, and then a colonial church. So those were the three cultures. And in the middle, there's sort of this large square. And there were thousands of people there. And all of a sudden, you know, the tanks came, the helicopters, and they shot into that crowd for 5 hours. And there was no place for people to escape. The only place they could escape was into the buildings, the high-rises, and the families began, you know, locking their doors, and so the bodies just piled up in the hallways and the stairwells, and there was blood everywhere, and the official death toll issued by the Mexican government was 26 people. But, you know, later they confessed, well, maybe 300, maybe 300 and something, and it's kind of estimated that it was probably around 1,000. And of course that put an end to everything, and that put an end to the magazine. I had to go into hiding. I had two paramilitary operatives came to my house. I had just given birth to my fourth child. She was 3 months old. And I was sick and I was in bed, and Robert Cohen is her father. And so he was at the house, and these two operatives came and asked for my passport and accused me of running a sweatshop and being a foreigner. By that time, I was a Mexican citizen, so I wasn't a foreigner, and of course, I wasn't running a sweatshop. So Robert said, oh, no, you know, she's a Mexican, and, well, you know, can you show us her passport? And so he did, innocently, and they grabbed it at gunpoint, and that was that. So at that point, I had to go underground. We had to take the kids out of school, the older kids. Robert had to quit his job. I mean, he couldn't go back to work. We couldn't live in Mexico. And at that point, we had to sort of figure out how to leave Mexico, because I no longer had papers. And that's when we went to Cuba. But the magazine just, it died, you know, a brutal death, because there was no way of doing anything with it after that.